Hello, and a very good evening to you, and thank you so much for joining me in the concert hall of the Essen Philharmonia. This is in Western Germany, and in this concert hall is a wonderful 2004 Kuhn organ. This is the first time that I've played it on the channel, and I really hope you enjoy it. It's so clear, and the acoustics are wonderful in this concert hall. It doesn't leave much space for anything to go astray. So we will start tonight's concert with the Prelude and Fugue in D major by Bach, BWV 532, with the notorious opening pedal scale.
Thank you.
Well, as you'll be able to have heard, the organ is super, super clear and leaves very little room for error, which is actually a really good thing for an organist. I think we've been spoiled by the likes of Rotterdam and Haarlem with those wonderful acoustics. It's actually refreshing and rather nerve-wracking to play on an organ so clear as this. I think Voxus Virtual Organs have done a terrific job at recording the instrument, and it does sound really, really lifelike, actually. So we'll go into something English just to show off some of the flutes on the organ. This is Percy Whitlock's Scherzetto. This is from his large, long organ sonata in C minor. So this is Percy Whitlock. Thank you. we'll just stay in England just for a while. This organ has an enchamard tuba. You don't often have enchamard tubas. They're normally a trumpet or something with a narrower sound. But yes, we do have an enchamard tuba in this wonderful concert hall. So it would be rude not to make the most of it. And what can we use to show the tuba off? Well, there's a piece by an English composer called Norman Cocker, who wrote, rather appropriately named, Tuba Tune, and it's for the tuba. So this is Norman Cocker's Tuba Tune on the enchamard tuba. This is the first organ, the only organ I think that I've currently got in the garage, as it were, in the Beauty and Sound fleet, with a real tuba. Rotterdam doesn't have a tuba, it's got Anschmar trumpets. The organ in Görlitz doesn't have a tuba at all. Haarlem certainly doesn't have a tuba. This is the only organ that we have. Korn definitely doesn't have an Anschmar tuba. So this is the only organ we have with a tuba on it, and it's actually really nice to be able to make the most of it. And I think it's a really rather good tuba. Really enjoy hearing that. It's really clear. Well, I hope you're enjoying this recital so far. Let's go into let's tone the volume down a bit and go into Lemare's Andantino in D flat. This is sometimes known as Moonlight and Roses. I played this in a recital a few months ago, and it was the infamous recital where Nala was just all over the place. She was all over me and all over the organ. And I seem to remember reciting the poem, the Moonlight and Roses poem, whilst Nala was sort of around here somewhere, crawling on me. Go and check that out. So this is Lemare's Andantino in D-flat, which incidentally, he didn't actually approve the lyrics. You know, he wrote this piece as an organ piece, and the words were added subsequently by somebody else, and Lemare didn't have anything to do with the lyrics. So this is, against Lemare's best wishes, Moonlight and Roses.
Thank you.
It's making use of the voxumana along with the tremulant, which of course this organ has, so I have to use it. This is now, well, this piece doesn't need any introduction at all. This is Louis Vierne's Carillon to Westminster. I apologise for the rather shortened programme this evening. You can go and get an early bath after this recital. I've been away at work and in London all week, so actually I haven't had much time to get to know the organ. So this is the first time that I've actually performed on the instrument, and I've had a few hours over the past couple of days just getting to know its quirks, and actually, well, there aren't many quirks at all. It works really well. It's a really, really good concert hall instrument. It's certainly got a lot of punch, which is why one of the reasons why I chose this piece. If this, if you need a piece to show off an organ's punch, the end of this particular piece certainly does that. If you like this instrument, go and check out the Voxus website. These are the same guys who recorded the wonderful organ in Harlem, which we've used a few times. These guys, I think, are people to look out for. They're doing extremely well. They're doing really good things. So go and show them some support. So this is the famous Vierne Carillon to Westminster on the wonderful organ in this luxurious concert hall. I can't really think of any other concert hall organ which has been recorded better than this one. I do think that if you have a need for a Hauptwerk organ in a concert context, you know, if you're taking out an organ and accompanying a choir or an orchestra, and you want an organ this sort of size, I can't think of anything better, really. It's so clear, and it, like I say, it does give that punch, and it has all of the right colours and effects. It's got an enclosed choir box and a swell box, as well as a crescendo pedal, so it's really well equipped. So I would really, really recommend checking it out, and really have enjoyed getting to know it. I think it's fabulous. I think it's, like I keep saying, it's so clear. I can't get over how clear it is, you know, playing Bach and playing contrapuntal music. It's so important to be able to hear what you're playing, the inner notes, especially. And on this organ, you can hear everything. So if you want an organ which is good for your technique, good for practice, I think this is the one for you. I will play one more piece. This is a piece by Paul Manz. This book was very, very generously bought for me by one of our Patreons. I'm very, very grateful indeed. And in this volume of chorale preludes, basically, and they're all five improvisations for weddings and general use. They're all on well-known hymn tunes, basically. And this one is on Now Thank We All Our God, Nun Danket Alle Gott. And it's rather good, I think. It's rather good. And it, again, makes use of the tuba. If you've got it, you might as well use it. So as I said, this was bought for me by one of our generous Patreons. If you are enjoying the recital and enjoy the music and other videos on Beauty and Sound, please do consider joining the Patreon club. You just get one or two things behind the scenes and one or two perks, which otherwise you may not get, and it really supports the channel. It really helps the channel to grow. Please check it out. So this is Paul Manz, Now Thank We All Our God, All Our God. And if you're anything like me, actually, I guess the British, the English organists watching will know Paul Manz for one choral piece, Even So Lord Jesus Quickly Come. Well aware of that piece, it's one of my favourite pieces for Advent. But this is the first piece, the first and only piece I ever play of his organ music. So this is a first for me. So this is Now Thank You All Our God by Paul Manz. Well, once again, thank you very much indeed for joining me and Caroline this evening. I do hope you've enjoyed this rather short presentation of this organ recorded by Voxus Virtual Organs. I think it's wonderful. I would love to know what you think. Please do leave me a comment down below what you think about this organ. So tomorrow we'll have our normal virtual church at 5 o'clock. Can't possibly have a Sunday without virtual church. It'd be great to see you all in the live chat there. Get your requests in. If you haven't been before, it's a lot of fun. Everyone gets involved. It's entirely live, so anything can happen. You know, I will only play what people ask me to play. And it is a lot of fun. The cats often get involved as well. So I hope you're having a really wonderful weekend. I hope you're enjoying this Saturday. And I do hope that you're keeping well, keeping safe, and keeping cool. I think it's generally warm, isn't it, everywhere? It certainly is here. So until tomorrow, thank you all very much indeed. And until next time, I will say cheerio. Goodbye.